shock and a bigger dynamics. So this stand is nothing but study of equilibrium state of bodies is called statics. So this is from the dynamics we got kinematics. The definition of kinematics is nothing but the study of motion of a body without, which means dynamics. The study of motion of a body without reference to any external force. We are not calculating whether the body is moving or not. That much only will calculate. So we want to know without external force. We are studying the motion of a body without considering who is giving the force, from where the energy is getting for the body. That we are not considering. That is called kinematics. Now under this is the right classification of so how the kinematics has come. You understood this one? Yes, you can write. If you have doubt, you can ask. Did you understand this one? No. Yes, you understood now this one. If anybody is there in waiting room, tell them. Tell me now. Everybody is participating now. Okay. Now like this. Now after that, I want to give the differences. Everybody will get confusion between two words, distance and displacement. Are you aware? Do you have the idea of distance? What is distance? What is displacement? No? Yes or no? Tell the answer in two words, let us. Do you know what is distance? Write in the chat box, beta. Yes or no? No problem. If you don't know, we are here to explain. Okay, I will teach you. This is one point A. This is one point A. This is another point B. Okay, A and B are two fixed points. They are not movable points. They will not move. They will not change its position. So a person is there at A. The person is going from A to somewhere at C, on point C. For that he is traveling 5 meters. And from C to is going again from B, and from B is coming here. Suppose this is 10 meters, and from B to B again 5 meters. Now, to reach from point A to point B, what is the total distance traveled by the person means you say like this. So, total distance denoted by letter, distance is denoted to the letter D. D means this B, or D is equal to what is the distance from A to C? AC. That means the distance between point A and point C plus the distance between CD plus DB. This is the distance. So it says this is how much total? 5 meter. We have considered 5 meter plus that is 10 meter plus again this is 5 meter. Total what is the 5? 10. 15 plus 5. That is 20 meter. Actual distance, you know, this is a rectangle, I think. A to B, actual distance is 10 meters. If the person goes in from A to B, he has to travel only 10 meters. But when he goes like this, he has to travel 20 meters. That is, which is more, 20 more or 10 more? See here, this the shortest way, that is the shortest path between two fixed points. See, this is AB. So that is displacement is noted by the letter S, and you write at this like this, a arrow mark on the top, S. That is why I will write, you will learn. So that is displacement is 10 meter. Now distance is greater than displacement. Distance is greater than displacement. What is happening? The total path traveled by a body, the total path traced by a body between two fixed points from A to C, B to D, D to B. This is called distance. See, bus is going in upward direction like this. Then changing the direction towards right like this. Again he is coming. Does he have uniform direction? Same direction? No. He is not having. So therefore, distance does not have direction, but it has only magnitude. A physical quantity which has only magnitude but no direction is called a scalar quantity. We know that distance is also a scalar quantity. BA. B to A is nothing but he did not travel. No, he came from like this. Again, he reached B. My aim is to reach from A to B. So B to A is nothing but this is displacement. The displacement is not a letter. Yes. Yes, what? Because it has direction from where the body is going. Body is traveling from A to B. One direction is there, and some distance is there, 10 meter. That is displacement. The shortest path between two fixed points is called displacement. Displacement has both direction and magnitude. Therefore, it is called vector quantity. Okay, and the unit of displacement is CGS unit. CGS unit is centimeter, and MKS unit is meter. Displacement. Distance is nothing. Distance for total path traced by a body called displacement, and the CGS unit of displacement is centimeters. MKS unit of displacement or SI unit is meters. For both displacement and distance, units are same. CGS unit is centimeter, MKS unit is meter. But distance is a scalar quantity. Why? Because it has only magnitude but no direction. Whereas displacement has both magnitude, means size, okay, size or length of a number in two direction. Direction is also there, going from A to B or coming from B to A. One direction will be there, only one direction will be there. So here direction is changing it every time. Therefore, we say there is no direction. So therefore, displacement is a vector quantity and distance is a scalar quantity, for which we are having some table is there. Immediately after the class, I will share this table to you. You write in the classwork. IIT physics classwork is there? Is there with you or not? I'm writing classwork. Yes. Okay. When you are writing this table, I will send in the WhatsApp group, voice group in your group. You see this table and write in the physics classwork. Understood? This table, I will take the photograph of this table and I will send in the WhatsApp. Okay, your WhatsApp voice group is there, no? In that I will send, after this class, I will send, you write this table in your classwork. He is saying this one. So, length, mass, time are discussing for total travel by the body. Total path travel by the body is distance, and the shortest path is displacement. Distance is a scalar quantity and displacement is a vector quantity. And next one, it has displacement has specified direction, where this is not having specified direction. So therefore, this is a scalar quantity, that is a vector quantity. These are the differences we are having. Scalar means, you know, physical quantity. You heard this word, physical quantity? If you did not heard right now, what is physical quantity? Physical quantity is equal to magnitude. Magnitude into unit. Everybody remember this one. The physical quantity is nothing but the product of magnitude and its unit is called a physical quantity. Example, when you go to a shop, general store, and you want to take pulses or you want to take rice, 10 kg. See, 10 kg you are saying. What is kg? Kilogram. Kg means kilogram, no? Am I right? Kg means kilogram, no? 10 kg means, yeah, that is nothing but 10 into kg and atom. 10 is what? Magnitude. Magnitude and then number cheptundi. Kg anedi unit. Yes, very good. Saira. Kg anedi unit. 10 anedi magnitude. This is magnitude. 10, 20, 30 numbers nemo magnitude ani antaru. Then unit untundi. Oka battala shop ni pothe em antaru? 1 meter cloth, 2 meter cloth antaru kada. 2 anedi magnitude. Ee meter, centimeter anedi units. If your milkman is coming to your house, you will take milk, no? 1 liter, half liter. 1 is a magnitude. Liter is the unit of. Unit of what? Liter is the unit of what? Liter. Liquids kada. Milk. Like that we are having. So if you take 10 dozen, 10 is nothing but their dozen is nothing but 12 unit, but that is units. Physical quantity is equal to magnitude into units. So class cannot be measured in liters. 10 kg, 10 is magnitude, kg is the unit. Yes, correct. So this is the physical quantity. Any physical quantity which has both magnitude, means magnitude means number, and direction. So where is your house? Means my house is 10 kilometer away from Kandankar school. Towards east or west, that should be there. Direction should be there. Only 10 kilometer means that may be around anything 10 kilometer. Okay, that's why my house is, here you will see saying that my house is 10 kilometer or 30 kilometer or 40 kilometer or 1 kilometer, 2 kilometer. So that number into kilometer, that kilometer is the unit. So a physical quantity which has both magnitude and direction is called a vector quantity. Example, acceleration, velocity, acceleration. I will tell what is acceleration now, coming classes. Velocity, okay. Retardation, deceleration or retardation, both are same. This kind of quantities, physical quantities are called vector quantities. And the quantities which have only magnitude, like length, mass, time, electric current, temperature, these kind of things, luminous intensity, these are called scalar quantities. Why? Because they have only magnitude but no direction. Okay, units will be there but direction will not be there. For those quantities we say scalar quantities. If you both the magnitude which have magnitude and direction are called vector quantities. The physical quantity which has only magnitude but no direction is not there, only magnitude is there, that those quantities are called scalar quantities. For that one also we are having differences. What are scalar, what are vector? After this class I am telling you, I will send this one, you write in the class. Okay, I will draw the class. Now coming to a concept, speed is equal to the total distance traveled by the body in the given interval of time or in given time interval. Again, I will repeat, the total distance traveled by the body in the given time interval is called speed. But we will write mathematically, speed is equal to distance traveled by time taken. So to travel certain distance, 1 kilometer, some time will be taken. To travel 2 kilometers, more time will be taken. So total distance traveled by the body divided by time, that will be giving you speed. Now we everything should be measured, no? Yeah, no, mathematically speed, you write here suffix speed is equal to, you write distance d by t. What is the CPS unit of distance? Centimeter. We will write centimeter, short form is CMS. Centimeter by second. Second, we write only SEC into S to the power of minus 1. This is the CPS unit of speed. See, I told distance is a scalar quantity, time is also scalar quantity. Distance scalar by scalar. What is the speed ultimately? It is also scalar quantity. Speed is also a scalar quantity. LKS unit if you want, meter, MTS meter per all second only. All we write meter into S to the power of minus meter per second. That is the LKS unit of speed. Speed is a scalar quantity. That means speed has only magnitude but no proper direction. This is speed. Okay, CGS unit of speed is centimeters per second. MTS unit of speed is meter per second. Meter into S to the power of minus 1, that is the unit of. You understood now? What is speed? Okay, speed. Now after that, when you come across Another thing, suppose velocity. Listen, velocity velocity denoted by the letter small v. Velocity v is equal to displacement by time. Displacement is denoted by the letter s bar by time. And you write v is equal to s by t. So this is a vector quantity, but time is a scalar quantity. Vector plus scalar is nothing but again you get vector quantity. Therefore, velocity is a vector quantity. It has both magnitude and direction. Velocity has both. See, Cs unit of velocity is centimeters per second, same like speed, and Mks unit of velocity is meters per second, same like speed. Okay, only formula is displacement by time is velocity, distance by time is nothing but speed. Speed is a scalar quantity, velocity is a vector quantity. Units are same, no, for both? Same or different? Same unit. Centimeters per second, both for speed and for velocity. Centimeters per second is the CGS unit, meter per second is the MKS unit for both speed and velocity also. Any doubts are there up to here? Okay. Now we are going to convert. In the next class, we are going to convert kilometer per hour. That means if a body is traveling 1 kilometer in 1 hour, then what is the distance traveled by the body in what is the distance traveled by the body in 1 second? That we have to calculate. That means kilometer per hour we have to convert into meter per second. And simultaneously, meter per second you have to convert into kilometer per hour. Understood? If a body travels 10 meters in 1 second, then what is the distance traveled by the body? Okay, in 1 hour. That we have to convert. For that we are having a small formula, and with the help of that formula we can convert. Now tell me, up to now how many are having doubts in this one? Kilometer per hour to meter per second to kilometer per hour. Now, when you are going on bike, if I ask you, hey, what is the speed with which you are going, means where you will see? If you are going on a bike, if somebody asks you, what is the speed, means where you will see? 1 meter will be there, no? Speedometer. Speedometer will be the needle will be coming. And that one, if the needle is on 50, you will say that 50 kilometers per hour. That is rotating, yes, that meter is rotating, no? KMPH, odometer, or speedometer, the name is there. That will show speed, that will show how many kilometers you are going. Yes, that will show that one. So, speed it will show, distance it will show, and revolutions of the wheel in 1 minute, that also it will show. So, that will be there. So, therefore, instantaneous, suppose suddenly we see the meter and we will tell the reading, no? That is called instantaneous speed. Speed at that particular instant. So maybe after that instant, the speed may increase or that may be decreased. So that is called instantaneous speed. Now fan is there. If you are keeping the fan in 2 number, the fan will be rotating with same speed or will rotate as it like. 2 number is on the quantity. Fan same speed. The speed is there to the other. Same, will the speed will be same with the fan too? Fan regulator will be there, no? So we have same speed, that speed is called uniform speed. Three means on the other speed at the end. That is called uniform. That means if the body covers equal distances in equal intervals of time, that is called uniform speed. Okay? Uniform speed. So here uniform speed are the uniform velocities are there, average speed, average velocity, variable speed, variable velocity, uniform, non-uniform, like this. We are having many kinds. So I will send the notes, today's note in your WhatsApp. Please write. And I think those who did not pay the fees, 20, we are getting the books. So take the IIT books as soon as possible. So 15th only they told. Come to school, visit the office, and receptionist will be there. They will. When? Today also you can come. By evening, tomorrow also. Yeah? then never there's a time you come and pay the money. On 20th you will be getting the books. Okay, this is the today's session. In this class session, if you have any notes, you can ask.